So, the ARK devs have been very busy doing their charity stream, and they've been revealing tons of Genesis things. In this video, we're going to check out the trailer, we're going to do a breakdown of it, and then I'm going to go through, like, just a bunch of the stuff that they have been revealing to us. There's more to come, so we might have a part two of this, I'm not sure, but, yeah. Guys, go ahead and hit the like button if you find yourself enjoying this one. We're going to roll the trailer first. Let's go.
Welcome, survivor. Enjoy the view. You see before you the pinnacle of mankind's ingenuity. All of humanity's hopes and dreams carefully nestled within this lifeboat. Each of its shining rings are laden with miracles of science and nature. A paradise where the boundary between the biological and technological has been all but erased. And now all of it is mine. I control this vessel now. I command its evolution, and very soon, its destination. From there, my will shall spread across the cosmos forever, infinite and undying. And there's nothing you or that witless puppet, that shadow of her, can do to stop me. I have already set my designs in motion. Our future awaits, survivor.
So, let's talk about the trailer. It starts off at the very end of Genesis, where you come out of the simulation, find out that there's going to be issues, Rockwell drags you out like this, and it just cuts to black. Now, the thing is that this whole map that you're going to see in this DLC, you were actually technically on this whole map, like, on this lifeboat and space, throughout all of Genesis Part 1. You were just asleep inside of the simulation, so Rockwell did not make this, but he is basically hijacking it and transforming it into whatever the hell he wants. So, yes, it's beautiful. It honestly is great. Basically, this thing housed a bunch of survivors, and it was heading back to Earth because Earth was cleared of element. Of course, Rockwell crash-landed on Earth when all the Arks came back, and he basically got freed at that point. So, yes, he's back, and he is the main villain. And by the way, in case you haven't already found out or you can't tell, he is voiced by David Tennant, who is a fantastic actor. Honestly, I'm so happy about this. As you can see, Rockwell's back. I mean, everything's looking aberration-y. He's definitely just, you know, experimenting more with all of the element and stuff like that to just kind of change things into his own vision. And we have some fantastic creatures here, along with Rockwell. Yeah, right here in a second, you're actually going to see Rockwell. I believe that all of these eyes and all of these little spores flying around are actually Rockwell. He's expanding himself. It's almost like a hive mind. I believe every single thing that you see here is actually Rockwell. And you can see his tentacles just there a second ago. So that one part of the ship that he's basically in, I'm betting that's probably going to be like the boss arena or something, because honestly, like, my idea is that he's going to be somewhere on this ship, and it's going to be somewhere hard to get, or maybe somewhere that we have to, like, obviously pay tribute to get into. But yeah, like, that's just going to be the boss fight. Maybe what we just saw a second ago was the boss fight, because that is him, and this is him that we're looking at as well. And of course, we have our cute little guy right here. So we're going to get into more details to do with this trailer, but those are just my thoughts and opinions on it. I might be wrong. I probably am. But yeah, let me know what you guys think. So to kind of further break it down, right here what we have is what they've been calling the tech trench. Now, they said in the live stream, right down at the bottom here, that there is water. I don't know if it's going to be an ocean, but I imagine that it's probably going to be a decent amount of water. And these guys around here that you can see, these are all just like robots, just kind of, you know, managing the ship. Like, they would have obviously been here before Rockwell. Maybe he has control over them now, so I imagine that they're probably not going to be tameable, but if they are, that's going to be really cool. They're carrying around boxes and stuff. Of course, we have pteranodons flying. Like, you know, this was all here before Rockwell just came and just attacked it. So we have Quetzals, we have some more robots and Brontos and some other stuff around the place. And it's honestly beautiful. One thing that they have said about this map is that it's actually the biggest map that is made for Ark to date, including, I do believe, including all of the, like, the ones made by, like, community members and, like, mods and stuff like that. So this is going to be the biggest map. Now, what we have is just a bunch of biomes that are actually attached to one another. We're not going to have a situation where you're going to have to teleport, which is really nice. So, yeah, obviously we have this beautiful Tech City right here. Tech City, I don't know what to call it. And then we have this lovely area here, which they've been calling the Eden Zone. And right here, we have the first creature. This is called the Strider. It is kind of just like a tech creature that you're able to tame. And they're all going to come with different attachments. So what you see on its head right here is actually the harvesting attachment. And I do believe they said there's like a bunch of different attachments that they can have out in the wild. I don't know if we're going to be able to craft all of these attachments and put them on, but they did say that different ones of these guys out in the wild would have different attachments. So you might end up running into one that doesn't have the harvesting thing, but it has something else. It does have a platform saddle built into the actual base unit. And then also you can see right here, it's got some sort of like a cargo hold or something on the side. I'm not sure what that is. And I think that this thing up at the very top is probably something different as well. Obviously we're going to figure out everything to do with these guys at some point, but, that's all we have for the moment. And oh, I do believe, I don't know if it's one of the attachments, but they said that there's also going to be a tech bed on the inside. So a tech sleeping chamber and a transmitter is going to be all inside of this dude, but they're probably going to be attachments. I would imagine so. But anyway, you can see these guys are just walking around vaporizing trees and rocks and everything and harvesting from them. Right here, we have just a couple aberration creatures that we've already seen before. But right here, see this? We have footprints from an invisible creature. This guy is called the Shadowmare, and there's actually going to be a pretty decent difference between the male and the female. Now, this right here is definitely going to be a female. I'll pause it on a nice frame. There we go. This one here is going to be the female because the female version of this is going to be able to turn invisible. And it's actually going to be able to make other Shadowmares around it. It's going to give them the ability to turn invisible as well, but only the female can turn invisible. The male has a bigger frill, almost kind of think of it like a lion, and it's also going to have the ability to roar and kind of give a pack bonus, I guess, to other Shadowmares. So basically what you really want is you want a male and a female. You can make the male invisible by having the female invisible, and you can buff up the female by having the male. So basically go around with a couple of these dudes and you're all good to go. But they also said that it's going to have a couple really cool abilities. It's going to be very agile, and it's going to be able to kind of like do a multiple dash attack. So it's going to be able to attack a bunch of creatures in a row. But as you can see, I mean, this thing's freaking beautiful. This is the first Genesis Part 2 creature that we saw. We saw this a few months ago with that little poster. And obviously, yes, everybody's been really excited for it because it looks really good. But right here, this has got to be a female one, so the male is going to have a bigger frill, which is going to be great, because honestly, this thing looks fantastic. I can't wait for this. It almost looks like it's aquatic as well because of its tail right there, but this is probably going to be the big creature that everybody always rides around on and stuff. You know, there's always one creature out of every DLC that everybody's obsessed with, and I feel like this is probably going to be it. Let's move on, because we have a couple new things here in a second. So as you can see, we have a little bit of a view of the biome right there, because basically what we've got in this whole map, it's just two giant rings from what I can tell with a trench kind of thing between them. And yeah, there's going to be biomes all the way around it, and there's going to be missions on this map as well, but they're not going to be kind of like in the world. You know, you're not going to be able to build in mission zones and stuff. You're going to almost teleport to mission areas, do the missions, and come back. And they're also going to be a little bit different from Genesis Part 1, because I don't think a lot of people really enjoyed the missions in that DLC. I actually did enjoy them. even though it felt a little bit weird, to be honest, in ARK, but I did enjoy them. Either way, though, I'm going to just call it. This is some sort of boss arena right here. It's gotta be. Like, these guys here are probably gonna come fight you, and then, you know, you kill a bunch of those, and then Rockwell appears. But, like, we've got Helena right here. We've got the survivor in the tech armor, which is obviously at the very end of Genesis Part 1, and we've just got tons of eyes everywhere. This has gotta be Rockwell's arena or something. But yeah, you can see, it's honestly just terrifying. And we have Rockwell tentacles right there. It's really hard to get a nice frame on that. Let's see. Oh. Okay, so that's probably the best I can get out of that. You can see there's just a ton of tentacles. So I do believe Rockwell, in his previous form, is going to be somewhat, I guess, still there. You know, maybe his face and his hair is still going to be there. But yeah, he's still got his tentacles. He's just got a lot more stuff going on. And honestly, this is really crazy looking. But yeah, we've got a little bit more to this trailer. As you can see, now we're at... This is the whole space station. This is the lifeboat. And he's hijacked it. And he's bringing us somewhere because we're taking off. We're going into, like, hyperspace or something. I would bet, because we're not going back to Earth. Like, we've got to be leaving Earth because Rockwell couldn't have somehow magically, like, went way out into space, found the lifeboat, and then taken it over. I bet that this thing was about to arrive on Earth. He gets onto it, and he just hijacks it, and now he's taking it probably to the original species of beings that that basically invented element. Because I don't know a whole lot about the lore. I gotta look up some bits, but I'm pretty sure the element came crashing with, like, a meteor, but it probably came from some sort of other species or beings or something like that. So maybe we'll actually learn more about the whole ARK story and kind of wrap up everything. I mean, we probably will, but anyway, you can see the space station here. It's really cool looking. It looks kind of crazy. And it zips off into hyperspace and roll the ARK logo with the cool Rockwell tentacles coming in and just enveloping it right there. It looks really cool. This is honestly the coolest logo. And then right here at the very end, this is actually, this is a new item that we're going to have. This is the, I think it's called the tech cameras. So it's going to be little cameras that you're going to be almost kind of like drones that you're going to be able to place around the map, and you're going to be able to, like, remotely kind of hack in, or not hack into them, remotely kind of use them and fly them around. So you can have them set up all around the map and then just fly them around occasionally looking for high levels. But as you can see, we spot a creature. I meant to try and get it when he was on the screen there. But right here, we've got, like, a little display of the creature, and it kind of almost shows, like, a dossier type thing. But yeah, this little guy is called the Noglin, which is the really cool looking creature. And then obviously he just opens up and it's just the most terrifying thing ever. Yeah, everybody's really excited since we saw this last week, but we didn't see this, and right now you can actually get a chibi of this in the game. It's already in the game. If you have Genesis Season Pass, if you have that bot, you can go ahead and just, like, kill your character and then respawn. You're gonna have a chibi of this dude, which is really awesome. This guy has some crazy abilities, though. This little thing that comes out of his mouth is going to basically, I guess, hack into your brain, because this guy likes to mind control beings and creatures and stuff. So you're going to be able to pretty much just use this dude and, I guess, mind control wild creatures, tamed creatures from enemies and stuff like that. And, you know, it's going to be pretty difficult to tame these guys. And they've kind of hinted at the fact that we might have to sacrifice creatures to them. But your creatures can also get mind controlled by these guys out in the wild. So if you're on your Rex or something, it can just get mind controlled by this little brain slug and pretty much just turn your Rex against you. So they're going to be very dangerous out in the wild. So you definitely want one to take over your enemies. But yeah, I don't know. This is going to be really, really strange and crazy. I can't wait to actually try these guys out. But it is, of course, a shoulder pet, in case you couldn't tell by the size of it. Oh god, that is just terrifying. Like, the freaking way he jumps at you. Like, look at that. That's just terrifying. I don't like it. I don't like it at all. No, it's actually really awesome. So, yeah, that is all the little bits from the trailer. I mean, like, I think it looks fantastic. This honestly looks like a really great map. You can see this is the ring right here. And you can see it's almost kind of like purpley over there. Wonder what that could be. Yeah, this is going to be just a beautiful map, I would say. And it's going to be the biggest map as well, which means just lots of nice places to build. And probably, you know, it could be a map that maybe a lot of people will want to make their main bases on. I don't know. I love this guy, though, this Shadowmare. God, he looks so cool. But yeah, you could just see, like, the environment as well. Like, very Aberration-esque, and it looks so good. It looks just fantastic. And I don't know what all this energy stuff is, but it looks just, I don't know. I don't even know what's happening. Just, it's so amazing. So I imagine that these are probably going to be known as like X creatures again. But we do have biome specific creatures right here. We've got an Equus, and right here we've got a Dillo. That's probably going to be in that zone with that Shadowmare. And then right here we have a Reaper. Very nice. This thing looks really cool. I love the colors on it, but that's a Reaper King. Is it going to be just a wild Reaper King that's going to come after us? Maybe. Either way, though, if it's like an X creature and it's a Reaper, that's even more terrifying because, you know, Reapers already have resistance plus extra resistance for being an X creature. People were saying in the live stream that they could be Y creatures. I don't know what they're going to call them just yet, but I don't know. I'm really excited. So these are just three of them that they showed us. They've obviously got more coming, probably the same amount that we had in Genesis Part 1. So, yeah, really excited about all these guys. It's going to be fantastic. So, they also showed off a bunch of other new items and kind of structures and stuff. Right here, we have the ammo box. And I guess the best way of describing this is, think of it as like a feeding trough for turrets and different things like that. So, we've got ballistas. We've got the things for catapults, whatever you call those. We've got like chain bolas, rockets, like just normal ammunition and stuff. So it's just going to feed all your turrets, which is going to be pretty nice. And you know what? It looks pretty aesthetic and cool. Next up, we've got the egg incubator. And this thing's going to be really interesting because we're going to be able to put eggs in here and set it to a specific temperature, which is going to make the eggs hatch quicker. So like, you know, if a Giga needs this specific temperature, set it to that and the Giga is going to hatch quicker than normally. And then also another really cool feature is that it will show the specific stats and colors and like everything like that, probably even mutations on the egg before you even hatch it. So not only is it going to incubate it down to 1% and basically make it ready to hatch out, it's also going to be able to show you whether or not it's even worth actually hatching up that egg or even just waiting for it to incubate. So very nice game changing structure. I feel like a lot of people are going to love this, and it's going to definitely save a lot of time with breeding for specifically like, you know, egg creatures. Obviously we've got the mammal side of things. I don't know, they might have some sort of contraption in the works for a mammal type version of this. Probably not though. I don't know, we'll have to wait and see. But either way, this looks pretty cool, and it looks very Jurassic Parky. I can't wait to have a bunch of these around because I really think that this is going to make a nice little centerpiece in some sort of breeding room. So right here we have the loadout mannequin, which is going to be a really, really nice structure. You're going to be able to place your full loadout into this thing. So all your armor and everything, it's going to dress up a little mannequin, basically just displaying armor pieces or armor sets. And you're also going to have all of your weapons and tools and stuff. So you're going to be able to walk up to this thing, hit one button, and it's all going to probably enter your inventory. Or maybe the armor will go on. I think that would be really cool. So you're going to pretty much just be able to put a full loadout into here. So maybe, you know, you might be heading down to the ocean. So you're going to need like an ocean set. So you can just walk over, grab your ocean set, and then be good to go. But you know what? Just for aesthetics, you could probably just put a bunch of these around with like flak armor and stuff. And I think it's going to look really nice. But yeah, this is something that I've wanted for such a long time, and I'm so glad that they're actually doing something like this. Even just aesthetically, this is going to be great. But yeah, the loadout mannequin, I can't wait for that. Next up, we have the hover sail, which is going to be pretty much just like a little, I guess, hover pad, and you're going to be able to sail it around and do different tricks and stuff like that to get little speed boosts. So one player stands on the back and kind of manages the sail at that point. And then you can also have another player kind of sit on the front part shooting. So if you want, you can have a buddy just shooting with you, maybe flying around like tranking a dino or something like that, while you fly it around and everything. But yeah, basically this is going to be just a little deployable thing. You're going to be able to put it away back into your inventory afterwards. I mean, it is pretty big, so I don't understand how that's going to be possible, but we'll have to wait and see. I'm going to take their word for it. It is just gigantic, though, to be honest. I mean, look at that thing. I think it's going to be really fun, though. It's going to be nice because, obviously, it's capable of flying wherever the hell you want. But I imagine it's going to take element to actually power. So yeah, might be something that we have to fight the bosses for or something like that. So next up, we have the tech bow, which is honestly something that I heard about a long, long time ago. I think it might have been in like a tweet or something. I don't know. I remember hearing about this thing years ago. Anyway, they're finally adding it to the game, and this thing is going to be really interesting. There is no actual ammo that this thing uses. Instead, it just uses element, and it has a bunch of different types of arrows that you can switch through by just actually pressing a button, I guess, while holding the bow. But as you can see from this little concept, up in the top right there, we have it basically all folded up. So obviously, when you take it out, much like most tech weapons, they kind of just, I guess, transform a little bit. So I assume when you take it out, it's just going to pop open, and then you can start shooting some arrows. So if you draw back the cord on this thing and basically charge the arrow, it's going to shoot like a bullet instead of, you know, shooting like an arrow where you can actually kind of dodge it easily. So it's going to be really interesting. A bunch of the arrow types, I would assume, would probably be like different Trank versions, but they did mention an explosive arrow, so I don't know, this thing's gonna be amazing. I really hope that there is like some sort of Trank version of this, because I think a new type of Trank gun, or I guess weapon, would be really nice in the game, because it's been a long time since we got something like that. But yeah, that is the tech bow. Honestly, it looks really cool. Cannot wait to check this thing out. So the last reveal we have for you in this video is the Federation tech suit. Obviously we've already seen this before. We've seen this in the very end of Genesis Part 1. The character puts it on. We didn't get to actually use it though. And then we've also seen this during this trailer and everything. And then currently right now we have the Genesis Chronicles continuing, and we're actually getting the skins for this suit. Well, the interesting thing about this tech suit is that it is not a thing that you have to earn. Everybody spawns into Genesis with one of these suits. It's just a starting item now, which is kind of crazy because it has the capability of flying and probably other things too. The other interesting thing about this is the fact that apparently it's like an armor set with stats and stuff, but it can also work as like a skin, so you can basically put on tech items. So if you had a really good chest piece or whatever, you can just equip that and it's gonna have this new look, but it's gonna have those stats. Yeah, this is gonna be really interesting. Just everybody spawning in with like freaking tech suits. It's gonna be a definite change, but it makes a little bit more sense when you think about it coming from part one to part two, because in the end of part one, we gear up in one of these and then we get dragged down by Rockwell, obviously. But you know what? Maybe in part two, we fall from the sky. I don't really know what's gonna happen, how we're gonna spawn in and stuff, but I don't know. I think it kind of creates this nice little link between the two DLCs that just kind of pleases me a little bit. Anyway, that is it for the tech suit. So that is pretty much it for all of the reveals so far. If you guys have enjoyed this video, do me a favor and hit the like button, because we got lots of videos coming out. We've got so much stuff coming, but also check out the Extra Life stream. They're still going strong. Donate. We actually raised over 20,000 here on this channel. I'm so proud of the community for that. So definitely go over there and donate. I'll leave a link down below. And yeah, thanks for watching. I'll catch you in the next one.